किया दल का वो पूरा मार लको हमरा उज्जर बचाओ ने जाओ पकड़ के हम पिटे लगा मारे लगा जुलुम करे लगा।
मम्मी को बेड से खींचा तो मम्मी नीचे गिर गई, तो फिर दीदी मम्मी से लिपट गई थी तो उसको बहुत मारा।
गर्दन में एकदम एक एक टांग यहाँ पास दिया।
Jharkhand has witnessed a spurt in witch hunting cases recently, and in the last 2 months alone, at least 6 persons, most of them women, have been victims of the social evil. If you believe this is a scene straight out of medieval India, then you're mistaken. This is happening in digital India. Humiliated, brutalized, killed, all thanks to our convoluted gender dynamics, women are being branded as witches in these times too. Witch hunting, a commonly used metaphor in politics, is deeply ingrained in gender dynamics. Several evil practices have been followed in India from antiquity, including sati prata, dowry system, etc. With economical and educational development, we have been able to eradicate many of such evil practices. Yet, the practice of witch hunting is still prevalent in many states of the country. More than 2,000 witchcraft-motivated murders were reported by the National Crime Records Bureau across 17 states from 2001 to 2014, most of the victims being women. The National Crime Record Bureau data for 2019 itself reveals that Jharkhand was ranked third in witch hunting cases and recorded 15 murders related to the crime. Chhattisgarh with 22 murders was on top of the list. A field report by Delhi-based legal resource group Partners for Law and Development, that is PLD, called it the proverbial tip of a very deep iceberg. Available data hides much of the reality. Only the most gruesome cases are reported. Most go unreported and unrecorded. In 2015, a Government of India status report on women described it as an outright discriminatory practice and a way to control women who do not conform to gender norms. It isn't superstition or illiteracy alone that spurs it. Neither is it restricted to any caste, religion, class, or the rural hinterland. A PLD study observes that superstition is only one part of a complex narrative. Every instance of witch hunting has a counter-narrative of motives. Some call it an outlet for men living in poverty to vent their frustrations, and women are easy targets. While others consider it having a strong link with land rights, targeting single women for land grabbing, or a caste-based practice where upper castes try to stigmatize the poor and indigenous people. However, that may not be the complete story. Even in urban areas, women other than lower castes or tribal communities are taken to quacks and shrines to rid them of the devil. The question then arises is that, has the criminal law system failed to act as deterrent? Poor police response, low conviction rate, long drawn and expensive legal recourse stand in the way of justice. PLD's 2014 study in Bihar, Jharkhand and Chhattisgarh also revealed that weak or partisan investigation, non-cooperation of witnesses and poor evidence weaken a case for conviction. Moreover, acts of public humiliation involved in witch hunting are not being specifically named in the IPC and are simply dismissed as injury. The existing laws also suffer from protection gaps. They fail to redress the long-term consequences of witch hunting, such as dislocation, loss of property, livelihood, economic and social boycott, etc. States like Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, Rajasthan and Assam have enacted special laws, but they have failed to stop killing of women. Such laws are inefficient, and lacking in accountability as the states never appeal against acquittals on behalf of the victims, creating an atmosphere of impunity. Criminal laws deeply rooted in social hierarchies and power inequalities have limitations in tackling violence. The law enforcement machinery being part of the same social context is not likely to take any preemptive action to save the poor, mostly women. RLEK's 2010 writ petition in the Supreme Court on behalf of 1,000 victimized Jharkhand women was dismissed, and the petitioner was asked to go for other options like approaching the elected women representatives. A bill against witch hunting was introduced in the Lok Sabha in 2016. However, social commentators doubt the efficacy of a national law as witch hunting is localized. Rather, they stress on an ambiguous criminal law of compensation and restorative justice for victims. The practice of witch hunting is a blot on our present-day society. Today, right to privacy, reputation, and internet have been declared as our fundamental rights. The country is walking on the path of advancement, but still, the basic right to a decent life is denied to people in many parts of our country. Nonetheless, stories of gang rape and lynching of witches make occasional appearances in the mainstream media. Yet, women continue to remain at the receiving end of violence under one pretext or another.